So welcome back to day two of competition here at the DANISA Denmark Open. Nozomi Okuhara, the former world champion and the only player in the women's singles draw to have made the final of the Denmark Open previously, safely through her first round against Kirsty Gilmore. Next up is home interest and it's women's doubles with Anthonisen and Graversen up against Akchurina and Morozova. Now, as you can see, this must be the bottom quarter of the draw because we have the number two seeds in this section, the two-time and reigning world champions, Matsumoto and Nagahara. So who will they play in the second round? We are about to find out. And this women's doubles, well, has been at the start of the tournament. In the women's doubles, seven seeds, and that's the most of any of the five disciplines. Only one pair, seeded pair, dropped out, and that was the number three seeds, Matsuyama and Shida. So, in theory, this is one of the strongest draws, but it also has to be said that only 22 pairs in the women's doubles, and of those 22 pairs, seven Danish pairs at the start of the tournament. That's very nearly a third of all entries are Danish. So they look a little nervous, don't they, the young Danes? Coming on, perhaps that's a little understandable. This is probably, do you think, the first time they've been on international television, Morten?
I think it is.
Yes.
I think it is.
Well, they both look lovely. They look well prepared, if not a little nervous. So our umpire for this one will be Bert van Horenbeek from perhaps some players will remember Akchurina by her maiden name, which was Cherbakova. One of the few, if not the only, active mother on tour. I can't think of any other players. Can you? It's a mother? No.
Not really.
Anyway, let's start with the Danish combination. Natasha Anthonisen is 19 years of age, born in Aalborg. Currently 115 in the world ranking, which is the highest that they have been. Her partner, also 19 years of age, born from your city, Morten.
Yes, Aarhus.
Aarhus.
Yes.
And perhaps you can help me out here, Morten, because I don't know an awful lot about this pair. Can you tell us a little more?
I think Clara is a very good player. She grew up in a club called Vibu, and there are three big clubs, Vibu, Aarhus and Højbjerg, and she comes from Vibu. And she's done really well. She's moving up the ranks and getting closer and closer to getting on to the national centre in Brøndby.
Excellent. Thank you, Morten.
You're welcome.
So to Anastasia Akchurina. And she, as you can see, is 28 years of age. Had success in international terms with several women's doubles partners. Tatiana Bibic, Natalia Permanova, who we watched yesterday in the women's singles. Nina Veslova was in six finals with Olympic bronze medalist Nina Veslova. And her partner, Olga Morozova, is 25 years of age and like Permanova, who we saw yesterday, also born in Yekaterinburg. And I won't give you a history lesson today about
ready to
Tsar Nicholas II.
I thought you were really good yesterday.
Well, as far as the Russians are concerned, they're making their second appearance here. 3 years after their first. They did enter last year, but didn't manage to get into the tournament. As I was telling you, our umpire from Belgium and our service judge from Norway. Well, I can tell you that the young Danes have in fact been in an international tournament final. That was last year, the Norwegian International Series events, lost to Carlsen and Magnussen from Sweden.
From Sweden, yes.
In the final.
Yep, the daughter of Maria Bengtsson. Magnussen. The former Swedish player really played
my era.
Extremely well. Yep, you must have played.
I certainly did.
Yep.
On my right,
women's doubles
Natasha
and mixed doubles player.
And Clara Graversen, Denmark. And on my left, Anastasia Akchurina and Olga Morozova, Russia. Olga Morozova to serve to Natasha Anthonisen. Lavol. Play.
So the Russian combination of Akchurina and Morozova.
Service over, one love.
Nearest to us in the blue and black kit. That's long. Talking of players
Service
from my
over.
Era, Morten, Olga Morozova. There was a tennis player called Olga Morozova. Do you remember her?
Vaguely, yes.
Yeah.
I remember the
Wimbledon those. Final, French Open final. Yep. Lost to Chrissy Evert in both. I think it was 1974.
Yeah, that's a long time ago.
Yeah.
Service over. Two,
in the era when
one.
We were watching it on TV.
Yeah. Just learning about sport and the beauty of sport in those days when we were just
watching Björn Borg.
Youngsters.
Coming up.
How long has this pair been playing together, the young Danes?
That I actually do not know. I don't know how long time this pair has played. But I would guess not more than 2 years.
Okay.
That's my guess. I once, not long ago, visited the centre of Peter Gay in Copenhagen, and Clara was on the training that day. I saw her there. So she's definitely really trying to do something with the badminton.
Mm. Nice rotational play by the Danes. Channel attack.
Three.
Here, the movement out to take the cross-court lift. That's a perfect example of what we term rotational play. Yes. Sharp work at the net
four,
from
three.
Graversen. There's the rotational play again. Good rally. Oh, my goodness. Brilliant rally. Oh, super change of pace from Morozova.
Serve is over.
What a rally, though. Easily the longest rally of the match so far. Quite possibly the longest rally of the day so far. Shots. Oh, yes. Oh, it's another good change of pace from Morozova. Was an opportunity. Well worked. Another excellent rally.
Yeah, it's nice to see that finally, you know, someone is finding the angle. And Anastasia did that, you know, the last shot she's playing, she's really finding the angle on that one. A lot of the smashes are going straight towards the person. That's why we get these long rallies. There's not enough angle and pressure on them. But the last one here, that was a good shot. Very good shot.
Service fault called
on Akchurina.
5-7. Service over. 6-7.
Umpire calling that serve as landing in. I think it was the correct call too.
Quickly.
17. Yeah, clearly in. Short. Yeah. And back level.
7-7.
Oh, what a serve.
That was really, really good.
8-7.
That was fabulous. Changing direction. Instead of going for the tee, serving out wide, and she played it to perfection.
How many times have we talked about that?
Burying the serve.
Yes.
Yeah.
How many times?
Service fault called. This time.
That's also a kind of variation.
Yeah.
8-8.
On Anthonisen. Good work by the Danes.
Serve is over. 9-8.
Oh,
Serve is over. 9-0.
Bronze medalist from the European Championships 3 years ago, which was staged in Denmark in Kolding. Don't at least one of them also play in the Danish leagues? Russian players must like playing here in Denmark.
Yeah, a lot of players are playing here.
11-9.
And they
interval.
Go to the mid-game interval with the advantage. A two-point advantage, 11-9.
The Danish league and the German league are quite popular in Europe,
yeah.
I'd say.
Når de server de korte server, så enten bare spille dem blødt ned under netkanten. Altså, lad være med at begynde at lave de der tryk opad. Spille dem blødt ned under netkanten, eller hvis du vil trykke, så på kroppen af dem. Og ellers synes jeg, det har været rigtig fint. Når I kommer frem af jeres offensiv, sådan på midtbanen, så spil med flere vinkler og gå ud side om side.
Well, we can't actually hear the Russian coach. But there has been Russian success in the women's doubles. Partial success, I should say, in the not-too-distant past.
Yeah.
10 years ago, semi-finalists Valeria Sorokina and Nina Vezlova lost out to the eventual champions Maeda and Suetsuna.
10-11.
That's another good serve. I like the way the Russian pair are varying the pace, especially in situations. Previously, I've mentioned Morozova doing it. That time, it was Akchurina. But I like that change of pace, Morten.
It's always important to have variety in whatever you do. I really think that, you know, if you just keep the same pace, the same pressure, your opponent is getting used to it. So I completely agree with you. But I think the Russian pair is having a tendency to serve a lot of high services. And again, when we talk about variation, more short services or low services needs to come into play. Danish coach was Michael Kelsen, not to confuse with the player Michael Kelsen, because that's not one and the same. A lot of people have confused that one.
Yeah, great height difference between the two Michael Kelsens.
Yeah, the player was somewhat shorter. Yeah, Michael Kelsen played men's doubles with Mark Christensen and got to the final of the All England 1 year.
That's right.
Bronze medalist at the World Championship as well in men's doubles. But that's not the same Michael Kelsen sitting behind the court. I've actually had that question quite a lot.
No, Michael Kelsen, the player, was a left-hander, wasn't he?
He was a left-hander, yes.
With the gentle giant.
Yeah.
Off court, that is. He was quite fiery on court.
Yes.
Serve is over. 14-13.
nobody's really been able to take control of this, have they?
No, it's a little bit of a dogfight, isn't it?
It is.
You know, get a little bit of initiative and then try to finish a rally fast and furious. And that's an awesome interception there from Clara.
30.
Really well spotted. Good anticipation.
Oh, I think that may have been going wide of the centre line. Yeah. Just beginning to
17,
impose
13.
Some dominance now, the young Danes.
Tries to look at 14, the attack from 17. Clara. She's very, very much often opting for cross-court attacks. Try to have a look. There are lots and lots of cross-courts coming. And if the two Russians are more aware, they would just start capitalizing on that. Because 15, Clara is really 17. Opening up the court as and when she's going cross-court. So straight counter-attacking shots would really be beneficial for the Russians.
Definitely the pair, the Danes, that's given them more of the attacking play. And that 18, is vital 15. In doubles.
Yeah, it just proves the point that, you know, in attack is by far the best, and the Danes are having by far more attacks at the moment,
yeah.
And that's why they're winning.
That's gone long. 2 points away from the opening game.
19-16.
That was a nice idea.
Serve is over.
Long execution.
19.
Oh, that's landed in. She could have played that.
18,
that's a misjudgment.
19.
So just 1 point in it. Game point opportunities.
20, game point,
Anthonisen
18.
And Graversen. One time she wanted to go straight on the attack.
19-20.
Maybe that's the reason. Yeah, it's a close match.
Yeah. Opening game to the 19-year-old Danes. A very tight opening game.
First game won 21-19. By Natasha Anthonisen and Clara Graversen, 21-19.
Umpire just confirming that scoreline. Anthonisen and Graversen, 21-19
in 19 minutes. Det, der åbner dem I starten, det at de begynder at lave de vinkler helt ude I deres så bliver der åbent også I midten på deres baghåndsside. Altså, det jo mest Olgas baghåndsside, vi kører efter, ikke? Men altså... vel lige lidt for mig her til sidst, men eller I spiller jo helt rigtigt nu. Altså, når I serverer situationen, når de serverer langt, stejlt ned I fødderne, det behøver ikke være hårdt. På de korte serverer blødt ned under netkanten. Alt det. Ikke gå ind på midtbanen og tage de der slagsmål. Stop den af ude I hullerne, og så gå frem der. Lige så snart I kommer lidt frem på i jeres offensiv, så vinkel på den vej ned I bagen og træk ud side om side. Og så der fin plads inden, som I siger, I midten, og det har altså mod den spiller.
Altså, jeg tænker mest på de der korte bolde, vi får, fordi hvis vi skyder dem direkte, så kan vi jo tamle dem op.
Ja.
Men hvis vi skyder midt I dem, så...
Ja.
Men nu lige lidt ned igen, og så klar, ja.
Men det rigtigt, som du siger, det med, at hvis det bliver lidt løs, så skal vi være klar på lige nu, så sætter vi meget frem og trykker.
Ja.
Dem der, vi ligger kort til midten, når vi har trykker.
Ja, det gør de.
Ja. Og
den der variation, du lige lavede, den
kigger
hen over dem.
Court 1, 20 seconds.
Okay, kom så. Klar igen.
So Michael Kelson takes leave of the field of play. Couldn't hear what the Russian coach was saying.
Wouldn't be able to understand it either.
Second game.
No.
Love all.
Niet.
Play.
So, as Anthonisen and Graversen get this second game underway, Morten, what was a summation of what Michael Kelton was saying? Well, it was a discussion. It wasn't one-way traffic.
No.
Discussion at all. So, just give us a brief outline of what was said.
A lot was said, but the gist of it is we're happy. Things are going well, especially from the mid-game interval. It's going our way and just keep it going, more or less.
So no new tactics or be aware of this?
They had one of the key issues is to try to attack Olga on her defense on the backhand side. Not on the forehand side, on the backhand side. Which I found a little bit odd, and I will try to study it whether that's an option.
Yeah.
1-0.
Frustration there for Akchurina.
2-0.
good angle from Graversen. I've been looking at that Olga Morozova defence. She's got some sort of a funny grip on her backhand defence. Have you noticed that?
Yeah, I have noticed it. I have.
But normally, technically, it's much easier to defend backhand than it is forehand.
Yes. That's why I felt it was a bit odd, but maybe he's right. I just haven't noticed it yet. It's clearly to see that Morozova, when she's playing that defensive shot, whether it's forehand or backhand or whatever, she is not very good counter-attacking, which means that the defensive shot that's coming is you don't really have to watch out. You don't have to really be careful, because what's coming back is another opportunity to attack.
So she's just lifting it, basically.
She's lifting it. Defensive shot there from Olga.
That was good defense as well from Akchurina. Had to sway her body to get out of the way to play that forehand defense. That's really magnificent play from Anastasia. On the body. Was she just slow to react, or is that technically something wrong there?
She allows the shuttle to get too close to her body.
Yeah.
There's not enough space, which gives her very little time to maneuver, very little options to play. It's simply getting too close to her body every single time.
Yeah.
Over.
A very, very poor drop shot. The quality of that second last shot was really, really poor. It's coming here. That one there, way too high. Cross-court drive was a very risky one from Graversen when she was going cross-court, but she got away with it. She got a mistake from her opponent, but it was complete open court straight down the line.
7-6. Thank you.
Well, that's nice. That time, the cross court from the forehand side of Graversen. And followed forward. I think that was important too, Morton.
That one there.
Yes.
She's covering that block shot straight away, which is good.
I did well to see the gap.
Yeah, this match can go either way at the moment.
Yeah. Nice angle. Good rally. Morton, did you notice right at the start of that rally, serve from Graversen to the tee, low serve to the tee, and she went back for the lift.
Yes.
That's extraordinary in women's doubles.
It is.
I don't think I've really ever seen that before. You see it sometimes in men's doubles, but if you serve low, usually in doubles disciplines,
you move forward.
Level doubles, that is, you move forward, you cover the net area.
Yeah.
Good return of serve, perhaps wasn't the best of serves, but still a good return.
It's nice to see when players are that aggressive on the return of serve. This is an example of what happens when you go cross court and there's not enough pressure. Try to look at this one. The smash is coming cross court and the straight reply here, that's the one. And that's the problem when you go too much cross.
Oh.
And here we have another example of it.
Yeah, huge gap.
9-10.
Well worked. And to the mid-game interval. Same scoreline, 2 point difference between the two pairs as we had in the first game, but in the second game the advantage, unlike the first, is with the Danes.
Du skal bare så komme frem med din defensiv. Du må ikke stå for langt tilbage. Nu er det med, at I er her. I er rigtig gode. Nu skal vi lige hjælpe hinanden her med at blive ved med at holde kommunikationen. Når I laver de der kryds mod Olgas baghånd, så skal vi råbe hinanden ud, så vi kommer på den. Og I bliver ved med at have det her smil på læben og kommunikere, ikke?
20 seconds. Thank you, coach. It's Clara to serve. 11-9. Play.
So more advice from Michael Coulson. Pretty much the same, just encouraging and you're doing the right things, or was there anything new?
More of the same. I found it interesting. Reserve it did not come from 10, Michael Coulson, but it actually 11. Came from Clara Graversen. When she said that she felt they had good opportunities when they occasionally gave away the initiative by lifting, of course, not just lifting it very high, but some good attacking flat lifts, and then taking one step forward and really trying to attack that smash that's coming. And I think she's got a point on that.
12-10.
Yeah, pressurizing the defense of Anastasia Akchurina.
13-10.
First forehand, then towards the right hip. Subtle variation has a big effect.
Women's single from Ukraine, Anna Dibakova.
Sometimes I think Anthonisen gets a little too close to the net.
Yeah, that's one of the things they have discussed in the big game interval. That's good. Well spotted.
Yeah.
They have. She is a little bit too close, and Michael Cousin has pointed it out that, you know, half a step back at least.
Mm, yeah.
But I think, though, that she's very decisive as and when she's getting into
it. Yes, absolutely. But sometimes I feel that she's slightly late on it because, of course, the nearer you are to the net, less time you have to see the shot and time to play the shot.
And too many shots are passing you.
Yes.
Serves over. 15-11.
Graversen, to me, is a busy player on court. Would you agree? Do you know what I mean by that?
Yes, yeah.
Yeah, she's always sort of...
On the go.
On the go and looking to do things.
Yeah. There's no doubt her mobility is one of her strengths.
Yeah. Now, that's a perfect example of being a little too close to the net, too big a swing, and therefore you can't time the shot.
Yes. Haven't got time enough?
No. Missed it.
13-15.
Oh, that was nice. Oh, that's loose. Oh, my goodness.
More than once.
14-15.
Yeah, she did well to get the first one back after that loose block, didn't she? 1 point in it. Yeah, she got back well to that flick serve. Yeah. You're right, Morton. There's an awful lot of flick serves. The names beginning to look for them, wait for them.
Yeah, perhaps even just a few inches back and then being able to attack it better.
Yeah. Graversen. an indication that they're feeling really confident right now. 3-point advantage and only 4 points from booking their place against the reigning world champions.
And that would be some sort of an experience, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
Ah, good variation there from Olga. That was nicely played.
Service over, 15-17.
One of your favourite situations.
3-point advantage.
3 points and 3 points.
And 3 points from victory.
I just
missed me, haven't you? You've missed me, Morton, haven't you?
I have. It's so great to be back.
It is, isn't it? It's wonderful. Good attack from Anthonisen.
19-15.
Yep, she's done it again. Low serve, took the push to the backhand corner.
Yep.
Serve is over.
The interesting of the return of serve was placed to the forehand
16,
net.
16-19.
It would have been an outright winner.
My goodness.
Indecision.
Yeah. I think it was going out. What do you reckon?
Yeah, I think so too.
Seem to snatch at it a little. Yeah, switching the attack.
Serve is over. 20 match
points. Brings up match point opportunities. Asking, and the young Danes Anthonisen and Graversen book their place in the second round, where they will play against the two-time reigning world champions,
Matsumoto
and Wakana Nagahara.
21-17.
So, as the umpire has just confirmed, 21-19, 21-17. This is the final rally, and having turned their defence into attacking play, one felt there was an inevitability about the outcome of that rally. Delight for the young Danes. 44 minutes just under, and 21-19, 21-17. So welcome back to day two of competition here at the DANISA Denmark Open. So success for the Danes in our fourth match of the day. Our next four matches are all singles. We've got second and third women's singles coming up, followed by the second and third men's singles of the day.